In this video, we will cover the different tools and settings for a spreader operation on the Ag Leader InCommand mapping screen. When applying fertilizer with a spreader, it is helpful to know where to find settings and tools available on the mapping screen to work efficiently and ensure proper application throughout the operation. From the home screen, tap the application app and select the desired configuration. With the configuration selected, tap Next. Select the season, grower, farm, and field, then tap Next. On the product selection window, if you have just one bin, select the product you are applying. If you have multiple bins and the InCommand 1200, you have the option to use container sequencing. With this function, the same product can be in different containers, and when one container is low or empty, the system will automatically know to switch to the next designated container in the defined sequence. For this example, we have two containers and both have the same product. To connect these containers, tap Container Sequence in the lower left corner. Next, we will select the containers that will be sequenced by tapping the bin icons at the top. We need to choose the trigger that will tell the system to use the next container. Manual only is used when the operator wants to control the sequence by tapping the container icon on the mapping screen. The low container sensor automatically triggers the sequence to occur when the product level falls below the sensor in the bin. Container low allows the sequence to happen automatically when the system reaches the low container level alarm, which you can specify from the mapping screen. The container empty setting triggers the sequence to automatically advance when the container level reaches zero as calculated by the display. After these settings are defined, tap the green check to return to the product selection window and select the product you wish to use and tap Next. Select the controlling product if using a dry blend. Tap the green check. With a spreader configuration loaded to the mapping screen, we will first look at the bottom of the screen. Here we will see two icons. The first shows the conveyor RPMs and the second shows the spinner RPMs. These values can be helpful throughout the operation to verify that the conveyors and spinners are working as expected. To allow the container sequence trigger to automatically switch to the next bin, tap the checkbox next to Automatic on the bottom. Next, we will tap on the wrench to open the spreader control options window. Here we can enter or adjust the product density. We recommend measuring the product density daily because it can vary by load. We can also enter the feed gate opening measurement, which should be adjusted based on product and target rate. To determine the conveyor rate, a static calibration needs to be performed. An in-field calibration is performed if there is a difference between the amount of product that is actually being applied and the amount of product that is recorded by the display due to inaccurate static calibration values. Video tutorials for both calibrations are available on our YouTube channel. Next is the chain oiling routine button, if supported by your spreader. Before starting the routine, remember to manually disable the spinner hydraulic circuit. With the spinner disabled, we can set the routine duration, and we can start the routine for the time specified. During this time, the bed will move at 20 RPM. After the routine is finished, remember to enable the spinner hydraulic circuit again. Ag Leader recommends performing this routine daily before you load product in the bin. Back on the spreader control window, we can adjust the spread width by tapping the keypad and entering the desired width. If you are controlling spinner speed, you can change that here. Tap the back button to return to the mapping screen. On the bottom right of the mapping screen, if you are controlling spinner speed, you can engage and disengage the spinners by tapping the spinner icon. Looking to the upper right-hand corner of the mapping screen, we will find the rate tab. This tab will display the product name, units for target rate, and as applied rate on the rate tab. When the selected product is dry blend, verify the shown target rate of the dry blend is what you actually want to apply. The rate can be based on the total dry blend, but if a product within the blend is displayed, it means that the target rate is based on that single product within the blend. For this example, we are adjusting and monitoring the rate based on the total dry blend product created. When tapping on the rate tab, we see more tools and settings revealed. Starting at the top, we can select target rate 1 or target rate 2, manual control, prescription map, and increment settings. tap the wrench to open the Rate Control Settings window. On this screen, we can set the target rate values, define increment values, and import a variable rate prescription if available. When these options are set, tap the Containers tab at the top. Here we can fill, empty, or specify the amount of product in each bin. By tapping the bell icon, we can set a container threshold amount and an alarm to notify you when the container reaches the defined amount or percent of product that is left, so we know when to refill. Tap the back arrow to return to the mapping screen. Now you will be able to efficiently use the tools and settings for a spreader on the InCommand display. If you'd like to learn more on spinner spreader control, please reference the InCommand feature user guide for DirectCommand spreader. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.